Okay, welcome back. Today in my last session of Antenna, a brief introduction, I will be recapitulating whatever we have done in the entire course. So to begin with, what was antenna? If we recapitulate what we discussed about antenna, we have discussed about antenna as a structural device which is used to collect or radiate electromagnetic wave. We have also discussed about the concept of antenna, where it has been defined as a transducer converting electrical energy to electromagnetic energy and vice versa. Whenever it is used in case of transmitting station, it is converting electrical energy to electromagnetic energy, and if it is used in the receiving station, it is converting the electromagnetic energy to electrical energy. So it is basically used as a transducer. So with this concept, let's move on to the parameters that we have discussed. We have discussed about directivity and gain. Directivity is of prime importance. Whenever we talk about antenna and antenna design, we have to keep the gain and directivity in mind. Now, we have, if you remember, we have defined directivity as the capability of the antenna to concentrate the power in a particular direction. So, the directivity definition was the ratio of the radiation intensity in a given direction from the antenna to the radiation intensity averaged over all direction, which sums up the factor of its capability to concentrate the power in a particular direction. Now, the next point was, the next parameter was gain. Now, gain was nothing but the ratio of the power at the input to the power radiated from the antenna. It is nothing but the ratio between the input power and the radiated power. Now, if my antenna is acting, if the gain of the antenna is negative, so that means, can I use the antenna? No, we can't use the antenna, because if my gain is negative, that means it is not radiating anything. It is being acting as the attenuator. So, for the antenna to be a radiating element, the antenna gain should be positive. It can't be negative. If it is negative, then it is acting as an attenuator. Well, then we have discussed about the classifications of antenna. The most primary element for antenna classification was the radiation capability of the antenna, based on which we have defined the isotropic antenna. Now, what was isotropic antenna? Now, isotropic antenna was the antenna which can radiate equally in all direction irrespective of the space coordinate, which is usually, this isotropic antenna is usually taken as the basic reference for modeling or for designing the other practical antennas. Then for directional antennas, we have discussed about the main lobe or the major lobe. What is the main lobe or the major lobe? Main lobe or the major lobe constitutes the lobe which is which signifies the direction where the antenna is radiating the maximum power. It is a direction of maximum power radiation from the radiation pattern of the antenna. The next parameter which we have discussed, which is of utmost importance after the main lobe, is the null. Now, in the ideal case, in the null direction, that means there should be no radiation in that particular direction. But in practical cases, what actually happens is that very less radiation occurs in the null direction. That means radiation is not totally zero in null, but in ideal case, radiation should be totally zero in the null case, null direction of the antenna. After that, we have seen how the radiation pattern looks like. We have seen the radiation pattern for isotropic antenna, we have seen the radiation for directional antenna, and we have also seen the radiation pattern for the omnidirectional antenna. Now, radiation pattern, if I sum up, it is nothing but the spatial distribution of the radiation of the antenna in all the direction in the different space coordinate. So, likewise, I can plot the radiation pattern of antenna in 2D and 3D pattern also. And so, likewise, it will give us the brief overview of how the antenna is radiating or what is the gain of the antenna. We can easily get from the radiation pattern. Then we have also discussed about the radiation resistance, and we have stated that if my antenna is acting as a radiator, it is radiating power. So, if power is involved, there is some sort of current that is flowing through the antenna is also relatable. And what is relating the power and the current? what is the parameter? It is nothing but the resistance, and as it is involved with the radiation of the antenna, it is known as the radiation resistance, which is equal to the power radiated to the square divided by the square of the current flowing through the antenna. So radiation resistance is also one of the key parameters that we should require to design the antenna. And finally, the side lobe, we have discussed about the side lobe, where we have seen that it is nothing but the minor lobe, that is the direction, it is in the direction in which the antenna is radiating, not the maximum power but less than the maximum power. It is the side radiation of the antenna. So with this, we have also discussed about the different practical antennas that is possible, and we have also discussed about the different modes of antenna propagation, how the electromagnetic wave is traveling from one point to another, that is from the transmitter to the receiver. So with this, I hope you have obtained a very brief idea about antenna, what is exactly an antenna and how it can be used in a communication system. I hope after this lecture series you can easily answer this question. So for any doubt, if you have any doubt, you can reach me at my email ID that is shown in my slide. Thank you for watching this lecture series. Thank you.